Hi, let us understand how to use the playground within Play with Docker. As a part of Play with Docker, they provide a free lab where you can create 5 instances and you can try all the commands available as a part of this particular course. Of course, there are some limitations, like whatever the session that you are creating, it will be available only for 4 hours. After that, it will get deleted, and maximum you can create 5 instances. I can add the instance one after the other, or otherwise I can go ahead and use the templates available and create the managers and workers directly using this template. And I can go ahead and do the settings in terms of the terminal font size and other configurations I can do over here. Now let me go ahead and add an instance. All I need to do is click add instance. An instance will get created with the name node1 as the host name, and this is the IP address. And I can go ahead and execute the Docker command directly within this particular shell. Let me see Docker, and it provides all the help options. I can check the version, Docker version. So this is the shell to work on this particular node. So this has the community edition 19.03. Now, in case if I wanted another node, I can go ahead and create another node. Another node with the hostname node2 will get created, and that will have this specific IP address. Now let us go ahead and create a container and see how to access them. So I'm going to create a container, Docker container run in the detached mode. The name of the container, I want to give it as Nginx-1, and the port mapping, I'll do it as 8080. That means the 80 of this particular host will get mapped to 80 of the container, and I wanted to use the image Nginx. So it's going to identify whether the image available. If not, it's going to download and create the instance. So I do have the instance. I can list the containers that are running, Docker container ls. Yes, I do have the Nginx container running in the port 80. Now I can get the public IP address from this particular link. For example, earlier this particular port detail was not available. As I had mapped the port 80 of this particular host, automatically the link will be available. I can go ahead and open it in a browser. I do have the Nginx. It's as simple as that. So what I have done, I have started an instance and started a container, and within the container I am running Nginx and I'm accessing it in the port 80. It'll be a very good option to play around. The biggest advantage is I can start 5 instances and play around all the commands, and there are no restrictions. At the same time, the limitation is the session will be active only for 4 hours. After that, all the instances will get deleted. Now let me go ahead and add few more instances and create a spam cluster. So I do have 5 instances. I am into node 1 and I'm going to initiate the spam, Docker spam init. Here I need to provide the advertised address, the reason because this particular node will be having multiple IP address. So I need to explicitly mention which IP address, that is the IP address of this specific node over here, as advertised address 192.168.0.23. So it will make this particular node as a master, and it will provide the Docker spam join command. I can copy this using the copy option after right clicking. Let me copy the command and make sure there is no new line character available. As I had increased the font, it's going to copy by breaking the line. So I cannot directly copy and paste. Remove the new line character by pasting it in the notepad. So I need to remove this new line character and use it in the other nodes. Now I am into node 2. Let me paste the command to join into the spam cluster, and it will get attached as a worker into the node 1. Let me do the same thing in node 3 as well, and into node 4. So I do have 3 workers and 1 master machine. I can get the details using the command Docker node ls. So I do have a master, that is node 1 is the leader and node 2 are the worker machines, and it is having easily readable hostname as well. I can address it using the IP address or using the hostname. Each instance will have the capability to utilize 4GB of RAM memory, and it's very simple and easy to use. We can go ahead and delete any instance which is not required or created by accident and create more instances. So I am deleting the instance number 4, that is node 4, and I am creating a new instance. So everything, a fresh instance will get created. I cannot create beyond 5 instances. That is the limit set within this particular play with Docker playground. In a quick summary, we had seen the play with playground, create instances, and how to access the node from the public URL and from where to get the public URL once the port gets opened.